All right, we're back with the Fox News alert. The rabbi injured in the deadly attack in a California synagogue over the weekend, standing up to hate.
My congregation was gathered outside here, and I said, I got to do something. I got up on a chair right there, and I looked at our congregation, and I said, Am Yisrael Chai. We are a Jewish nation that will stand tall. We will not let anyone or anything take us down. Terrorism like this will not take us down.
The faith leader came face to face with that shooter and says the rifle miraculously jammed, likely saving lives.
One woman was killed in the attack as well. Let's bring in Sarah Sanders, White House press secretary. She joins us from the North Lawn. Sarah, good morning to you.
Good morning.
You know, the stories this morning, we have a couple of stories of heroism. An off-duty Border Patrol agent was there in the church. He had his service revolver. And then you've got a story about an Army vet by the name of Oscar Stewart, who actually ran toward the gunman. And then the gun jammed, which ultimately probably saved a lot of lives.
These stories are so powerful, and the words of the rabbi that you played just now are absolutely powerful, but so unfortunate that he has to speak those words to his congregation, a truly horrific thing that took place over the weekend, and something that should never happen anywhere in the world, certainly not in America, certainly not driven by this type of hate. Nothing could be, I think, a worse thing to happen than something like this in a place of worship. And the president has condemned this type of hatred, anti-Semitic behavior. He spoke to the rabbi over the weekend. He also spoke with the governor and the mayor and offered condolences on behalf of the country. And our hearts go out to these people. And again, this should never happen in our country.
Sarah,
and,
your dad.
Our hearts are broken as we see what's taking place.
You're right. Your dad was a pastor, church, and you know, most of us go to church or worship, you know, go to a synagogue or go to a mosque or go to a church on Sundays or over the weekend. And for the first time in my life, I'm starting to think about that when I'm in church. Am I safe? What is the president? Is there anything that we can do to make sure when people go to their house of worship that they are protected and their kids are protected?
I think that, like you said, that that's a place that you should feel safe. I'm thankful that when I am there, I'm surrounded by the peace and comfort of our Creator. And I think that is one of the most beautiful things about a church service. But you should never have to feel what those individuals felt in that synagogue over this weekend.
Right.
I think that we need to look at every way we can, not just in churches, but across the country, to look for ways to bring that level of hatred down. We have to call out this type of anti-Semitic behavior, racism, bigotry. We have to call it out. We have to call it out by name, and we have to continue to identify it and make sure that people know that it is evil and look it right in the face and call it exactly that. Anything that we can do, certainly I know the president and the administration are looking at ways that people feel safer in schools, in churches, and across this country.
Matt Dowd, an analyst on ABC, says this: I think the president needs to do at some point look in the mirror and understand that the rhetoric, the words he uses in all of this inflame a part of what's going on in America. It gives permission to the most craziest people in America. What's your reaction?
Look, I don't think anything could be further from the truth. We have a president who has a heart for people. That's why he ran and became president. It's because he cares about people, he cares about this country, and he wants to see it succeed on every single level. And words like that aren't helpful to this process at all. Looking for how we can actually change people's hearts, I think, matters. The president has condemned not only this act, but all acts of evil and hatred and racism and bigotry, and we will continue to do that. And again, I think that is a outrageous statement and something that is a complete misrepresentation of who the president is and what he's trying to do in his administration.
All right. Something the president is trying to do is trying to fix the immigration problem. And Jared Kushner said last Tuesday, a detailed plan for a merit-based immigration system will be presented to the president, giving priority to skilled immigrants rather than those with family ties to the United States. Do we have a timetable on this when we're going to find out more about it?
We're still working through that process. I expect that to be over the next couple of weeks that plan will be rolled out. In the meantime, we're still calling on Congress to help us fix some of the immediate things that could be done. The border is completely broken. We're seeing that more and more every single day. There is a true humanitarian crisis at the border that has to be addressed. We have children coming in record numbers, unaccompanied minors just skyrocketing. It is inhumane what is taking place, and the fact that Democrats aren't willing to work with the president to help.
But Tuesday
us
they are. Sarah,
that.
Tuesday, Nancy Pelosi and Chuck Schumer are coming to see the president. They called for the meeting. Will the president bring that up? Does he expect to walk out with maybe some concrete steps both sides can take? After all, 60 minutes and the New York Times is saying it's a crisis. Do you expect something to come out of that meeting on immigration?
Look, the primary purpose of that meeting is to discuss infrastructure, but I certainly wouldn't be surprised at all if immigration comes up. It's a major problem in this country, and so far Democrats have refused to acknowledge it and address it. Hopefully they have, as a lot of the mainstream media who were really late to the game. But even, like you said, the New York Times has started to recognize this is a real crisis. Hopefully Democrats are seeing that as well and are going to be more willing to work with the president. Again, the purpose of that meeting is to discuss infrastructure and how we rebuild the country's infrastructure, another vital conversation that's been ignored for too long. This is a president who likes to build things. He knows how to build things and do it well. And I think this is a great place where Democrats and Republicans can come together, they can find some common ground, and actually focus on solutions instead of just the fighting that we've seen taking place over the last couple months. Democrats have been solely focused on attacking this president and ignoring all of the big issues in the country. And we hope that Tuesday we'll see a little change of heart from both Speaker Pelosi and Chuck Schumer.
Sarah, the White House Correspondents' Dinner was over the weekend, and last year the president hasn't gone the last few years. I know you were there last year and you decided to skip out on it as well. So you both went to Green Bay, Wisconsin for a rally. President was on stage, called you up on stage with him and joked around with you a little bit. Watch this.
Oh, she doesn't get it. She doesn't get it. She doesn't understand me after all these years. She's becoming too popular. I'm jealous. Sarah, you're fired!
Well, you had a good run.
Yeah.
Well, thankfully, he didn't fire me in real life. And we had a great night Saturday night. There were tens of thousands of people that came out to cheer on the president and cheer on the success of his first 2 years in office, which have been absolutely tremendous. It just goes to show that there is a lot of enthusiasm out there and excitement. People are happy that the economy is booming. People are happy that ISIS has been defeated in Syria. People are happy that the military is being rebuilt, that the judiciary is being remade, and that our country is booming like it hasn't in decades.
Right.
And they're very supportive of the president. You certainly
saw
that on Saturday night.
Well, it looks like a good time was had by all.
Better time there than in D.C. last year.
Yeah, and she wasn't really fired, as it turns out. Sarah, thank you very much for joining us live. Have
Thanks,
a good week.
Sarah. You bet. Thank you for having me.